So the iron law of performance can easily be applied when we spend a constant number of cycles for each instruction. But how about unequal instruction execution times, meaning we spend different numbers of cycles for different instructions? So this is our original iron law of performance, the number of instructions per program times the number of cycles per instruction times the clock cycle time. If we have different clock cycles per instruction, this part becomes a sum for all types of instructions, the instruction count of that type that we have to execute, times the cycles per instruction for that type of instruction. Note that in the original iron law of performance, this was really how many cycles we need to execute the program. This is how many cycles we need for each type of instructions, all of them in a program. And the sum here is simply summing up over all types of instructions. So this is still the number of cycles we execute in a program. And we still have the clock cycle time here. So the new CPU time here is like this. So if we have different CPI, meaning different cycles per instruction for different types of instructions, then we need to do this and just multiply that with the clock cycle time.